you know, move across our area overnight for some of our inland counties as a Category 1. It has weakened, but still the same results for us as we go through the rest of the morning hours as this quickly pulls away, moving north at 30 miles per hour. So it's headed up toward near Augusta and will continue moving through North Georgia and eventually to the mountains of North Carolina and Tennessee. Winds now of 70 miles per hour. What's going to happen? It's just going to stall out and fall apart over Kentucky and northern parts north of Nashville as we go into the upcoming weekend. And this is normally what happens. Things do weaken as they move over land. They lose that fuel source, which is really warm water temperatures of the Gulf of Mexico. Thompson Hotel downtown Savannah has seen a lot of power outages across the area. Of course, in downtown, seeing those power outages. Winds right now are right around south at 41 miles per hour. These are tropical storm force winds that we are seeing. And the tornado threat is quickly ending across our area, mainly from Savannah northward. We'll continue seeing that a tornado threat for just a few more hours, especially in the low country. Most of these cells here that have been water spouts moving up over land this morning, they're beginning to slowly move out of our area. So places like Charleston and points northward is seeing that. But most of the rain continues to wind down as well. Most of it is north of I-16, where we're seeing some of the heaviest of the rain still coming down very heavily there in parts of Sylvania, Statesboro, also Hampton, in Savannah, just seeing some lighter rain now, but still around the low country. This is Bluffton to Hilton Head, also Beaufort. Continue seeing those tropical downpours that are rolling through. And impressive sight as it made landfall earlier this morning there, the Big Bend of Florida, headed up toward Augusta, and devastating for further points northward from upstate South Carolina and the mountains of North Carolina. You're going to see some nasty conditions there later today. And notice this is a satellite loop. This is impressive as well, as it made landfall as a Category 4 hurricane, and then it moved up right across our areas, a Category 1 large storm. That's what I was saying the last couple of days, that this wind field would expand very quickly as it moved on shore. And you can see there it's right near Augusta where that center of circulation is, as it's moved right across our area overnight last night with those really strong gusty winds. So, Emma, as we go through the rest of this morning, we will see some improving conditions, but we have to get up to about sunrise before we see those winds really begin to drop off.